So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247. In today's session, guys, we are going to talk about the PIB news. As you can see here, 19th to 24th of October 2022. अभी बीच में एक दो दिन session नहीं हुआ था because of Diwali. I know you guys were busy in celebrating your Diwali and I hope सबकी Diwali बहुत अच्छी रही होगी. But now is the time to come out from the vibes of the festival and just focusing on your preparation. And you should give yourself, you should make yourself a promise ki agli Diwali tak aapke paas ek jo bhi desired aapki job hai wo ho, right? So beech mein news bhi bahut kam hai aur 19 to 24th ke beech mein because kyunki festival season tha to government ki jo departments thi wahan ki bhi chutti thi to isliye bahut zyada news nahi hai. But still total 14 questions are there in today's session, so please focus on this. And for the NABARD phase 2 aspirants, I wish you guys all the very best for the exam tomorrow. And jo bhi hai, jitna bhi aapne padha hai, bas honestly karke aana. Just don't lose out your focus and concentration during the examination. Right? Don't take it on your nerves. Just take a chill pill, just relax and give your best shot during the examination. Alright? So let's talk about the very first question, which says, World Spice Congress is the world's largest exclusive business platform for the spices sector. It has been organized recently by Spices Board of India, which works under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. The question is, where will the 14th edition of World Spice Congress take place? ठीक है, ये कहाँ पे इसका 14th edition इसका होगा World Spice Congress का? So remember, it will take place in the month of February 2023, next year. Right, in the month of February 2023, and it will be the 14th edition. And where will it take place? It will take place in Navi Mumbai, which is of course in Maharashtra. Now, what is the objective of this Congress? Objective of this Congress is to bring together the global spice industry so that they can discuss and deliberate the problems and what are the prospects in the spices sector. All right. Now, there is a theme also. Vision 2030 spices, that is the theme, but there is a full form of spices here, and that's sustainability, productivity, innovation, collaboration, excellence and safety. Since every letter has a meaning, so they can ask you about what is P in spices. Although it would be a very difficult question, but yes, these days they are asking anything. Theek hai, kuch bhi pooch rahe hain to ye bhi pooch sakte hain, right? So I would recommend you to learn this. ठीक है, लर्न द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ दिस. दिस इज सस्टेनेबिलिटी, प्रोडक्टिविटी, इनोवेशन, कोलैबोरेशन, एक्सीलेंस एंड सेफ्टी. ऑलराइट, नाउ इट विल बी ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय स्पाइसेस बोर्ड ऑफ इंडिया व्हिच वर्क्स अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड इंडस्ट्री, हेडेड बाय मिस्टर पीयूष गोयल. ठीक है, पीयूष गोयल इसके मिनिस्टर है. एंड इट विल बी ऑर्गेनाइज एज अ G20 साइड इवेंट. ठीक है, इट विल बी ऑर्गेनाइज एज अ G20 साइड इवेंट ऑन द साइड लाइन्स ऑफ इंडियाज G20 प्रेसिडेंसी. और इंडिया की G20 प्रेसिडेंसी कब से शुरू हो रही है, दिस कैन ऑल्सो बी आस्क्ड. सो इट इज गेटिंग स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम डिसंबर 2022 टू नवंबर 2023. ऑलराइट, सो दैट इज ऑल अबाउट दिस वर्ल्ड स्पाइस कांग्रेस. देयर इज नो नीड टू गो इनटू द डिटेल्स. और अभी तो ऑफकोर्स ये हुआ भी नहीं है, तो जब ये होगा, अगर कुछ अच्छी डिटेल्स होगी, देन वी विल डिस्कस दैट. ओके, सो इन द क्वेश्चन द लोकेशन हैज बीन आस्क्ड. सो इट विल टेक प्लेस इन नावी मुंबई इन महाराष्ट्र. ऑप्शन डी विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. Alright, I hope this question is clear. Moving ahead to question number 2. With which organization India Post Payment Bank has announced its collaboration from bringing innovations in financial product and services to enhance the reach of financial solutions to large sections of society across India? So basically, India Post Payment Bank has done a collaboration, and the question is regarding that only, that with which organization this collaboration has been done. So remember, it has been done with RBI Innovation Hub. You must have heard about RBI Innovation Hub. Gulabsa ma'am ne apne finance ki classes mein aapko padhaya hi hai, RBI 247 mein. So RBI Innovation Hub ke saath India Post Payment Bank has collaborated, and this collaboration is for bringing innovation in financial products and services and providing access to the remotest area of the country. But access of what? Access of financial services. All right. Now, this under this collaboration, what will happen? So basically, RBI Innovation Hub will take the advantage of rural reach of India Post Payment Bank. See, we all know India Post Payment Bank has a good reach in the rural areas, in the remote areas, right? So The RBI Innovation Hub will take the advantage of this reach and will provide access to financial services to the unserved and underserved people. Okay. Now talking about RBI Innovation Hub in short. So of course, as the name suggests, it was launched with an objective to create an ecosystem that focuses on promoting access to financial services and products across the country. Right. So uska naam se clear hai. I don't see any problem in it. It was established this year 2022 with its office or location at Bengaluru, and of course the parent organization is Reserve Bank of India. All right, iske detail mein aapko Gulab Sir ma'am ne padhaya hoga RBI 247 mein, so you can read the details from there. So with which organization this collaboration has been done? So it is RBI Innovation Hub. Option B is the correct answer. All right, I hope this question is also clear. Let's talk about question number 3. It is an important question. This can be asked. Consider the following statements with respect to India-Africa Security Fellowship Program, and you have to identify the correct statement. Correct statement aapko identify karni hai regarding India-Africa Security Fellowship Program. Remember, this fellowship program has been launched recently during the second edition of India-Africa Defense Dialogue. Now, this dialogue took place very recently during the DEF Expo, which is going on in Gandhinagar. Now, where is this Gandhinagar? It is in Gujarat, right? So, DEF Expo ke dauran, this dialogue was there, India-Africa Defense Dialogue. And during this dialogue, this India-Africa Security Fellowship Program was launched, right? Now, this program has been launched to give an opportunity, to provide an opportunity to the African students, African scholars, to pursue research on defense and security issues in India. India mein jo bhi defense or security issues hai, uske upar research karne ka mauka diya jayega to the African scholars. Manohar Parikar Institute for Defense Studies and Analysis will be the host institute for this fellowship program, right? Any scholar and researcher from reputed university, think tank, government official, defense officers, etc. will be eligible to research under this fellowship program. The duration will be 1 to 3 months, and the amount of fellowship that will be provided is 50,000 per month. All right, so that is all, and now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the correct statement. All right, Manohar Parikar Institute for Defense Studies and Analysis is the knowledge partner. Bilkul sahi baat hai. Fellowship is for the duration of 1 to 3 months. Absolutely correct, no problem with it. And rupees 1 lakh per month will be provided as the amount of fellowship. Is that so? No, it is not rupees 1 lakh per month, it is rupees 50,000 per month. So 1 and 2 will be the correct answer, option A. Alright, moving ahead to question number 4. This is about the mission life, and very straightforward question. You have to identify incorrect statement about mission life. And life stands for what? Lifestyle for environment. Bahut baar humne padha hai. We have studied it a lot of times. But yes, kuch log aap mein se naye honge, jinke liye dobara se padh lete. So it has been now formally launched. Isse pehle aapne padha hoga that Prime Minister has announced that life movement will be launched. Theek hai? And actually, iska jo idea tha, inhone COP26 jo Glasgow mein hui thi, wahi pe de diya tha. Okay, this idea was given by Prime Minister Modi during COP26, which took place at Glasgow. Now, let me ask you a question. Where will COP27 take place? Kahan pe hoga COP27? Okay, let me tell you the answer. It will take place in Sharm el-Sheikh city of Egypt. Sharm el-Sheikh city of Egypt, right? Now, it has been officially launched along with UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres, who came to India, they launched the mission life. And where did they launch it? From the Statue of Unity, which is of course in Kevadia in Gujarat. Now this mission, this movement is for safeguarding the environment from the impact of climate change. Basically, naam se clear hai, lifestyle for environment. Right? So we need to adopt such lifestyle so that we can save our environment. That is the whole idea behind this movement. Now, it will also bring individual behaviors at the forefront of the global climate action narrative, which means not only the governments are responsible for climate change, but the individuals are also the equally responsible. Okay, so ye individual ki bhi responsibility hai to save their climate. Ye sirf government ki zimmedari nahi hai, aapki aur hamari bhi zimmedari hai ki hum apna environment ko बचा सके, राइट? दैट इज द होल आइडिया बिहाइंड दिस मूवमेंट, राइट? नाउ इट अडॉप्ट्स थ्री प्रॉन्ग स्ट्रेटजी. नंबर वन, डिमांड, बाय नजिंग इंडिविजुअल्स टू प्रैक्टिस सिंपल येट इफेक्टिव इफेक्टिव एनवायरमेंट फ्रेंडली एक्शन. मतलब जो हमारे एक्शंस हो वो कैसे होने चाहिए, एनवायरमेंट फ्रेंडली होने चाहिए. वी नीड टू अडॉप्ट सच एक्शंस, वी नीड टू डू सच एक्टिविटीज विच आर एनवायरमेंट फ्रेंडली. देन सप्लाई, बाय एनेबलिंग इंडस्ट्रीज एंड मार्केट्स टू रिस्पॉन्ड स्विफ्टली टू द चेंजिंग डिमांड. नाउ वंस आवर डिमांड्स विल चेंज अकॉर्डिंग टू द एनवायरमेंट, देन ऑफकोर्स द इंडस्ट्रीज एंड द मार्केट्स विल हैव टू चेंज देयर सप्लाई. ओके. एंड फाइनली पॉलिसी, टू इन्फ्लुएंस गवर्नमेंट एंड इंडस्ट्रियल पॉलिसी टू सपोर्ट बोथ सस्टेनेबल कंजम्पशन एंड प्रोडक्शन. सो पॉलिसीज हैव टू बी मेड इन सच अ फॉर्म इन अ सस्टेनेबल मैनर. ओके. एंड इट्स आइडिया एज आई टोल्ड यू वॉज इंट्रोड्यूस बाय प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी ड्यूरिंग COP26. सो दैट इज ऑल. यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. इट इज अ ग्लोबल मिशन टू सेव गार्ड एनवायरमेंट फ्रॉम इंपैक्ट ऑफ क्लाइमेट चेंज. सही बात है. It brings individuals at the forefront of the global climate action narrative. Yes, it is the responsibility of individual. It proposes three-pronged strategy at demand, supply and policy stages. Bilkul sahi baat hai. And its idea was introduced by UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres. No, the idea was introduced by our Prime Minister Modi during COP26. So this should be the correct answer, option B, because that is the incorrect statement. Let's talk about question number 5 then. The 23rd annual general meeting of developing countries vaccine manufacturers network was held in Pune. Now this organization is not that important, but yes, we have seen that a lot of questions come from the organizations, right? So that is why this news is here, and iska jo annual general meeting hai wo Pune mein hua hai, and that is why it becomes important. It was organized by Serum Institute of India along with this organization only, DCVMN. So where is the secretariat of DCVMN located? DCVMN stands for what? Developing Countries Vaccine Manufacturers Network. ठीक है? So the 23rd AGM of Developing Countries Manufacturing Vaccines Manufacturers Network took place in Pune in Maharashtra. Now this was conducted to discuss on global equity and timely access of vaccines and future pandemic preparedness and response. बेसिकली अभी हमने देखा COVID-19 के दौरान किस तरीके से वैक्सीन का इश्यू हुआ था. सो टू डिस्कस ऑल दीज इश्यूज दिस AGM वॉज कंडक्टेड. नाउ इट वॉज co-hosted बाय Serum Institute of India एंड दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ओनली विद द थीम ग्लोबल इक्विटी एंड टाइमली एक्सेस COVID-19 एंड बियॉन्ड. नाउ वी आर थिंकिंग बियॉन्ड COVID-19. सो इन फ्यूचर लेट्स से इफ एनी सच पैंडमिक कम्स देन वॉट शुड बी द स्टेप्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, वॉट शुड बी द स्टेप्स टेकन इन द फ्यूचर, कि क्या होगा कि अगर इस तरीके का कोई पैंडेमिक आ जाएगा, राइट? नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, सो इट इज अ वॉलंटरी पब्लिक हेल्थ ड्रिवन अलायंस ऑफ वैक्सीन मैन्युफैक्चरर्स फ्रॉम डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज ओनली, राइट? एंड इट वाज एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन 2000 एंड इट इज हेडक्वार्टर्ड, इट्स सेक्रेटेरिएट इज लोकेटेड एट न्यो विच इज इन स्विट्जरलैंड. ठीक है? ऑलराइट. एंड इसका विजन तो ऑफकोर्स इसके नाम से ही क्लियर है, to protect people against known and emerging infectious diseases globally by increasing availability of vaccines. All right. So where is the secretariat of DCVMN located? So it is located in Nyon, which is in Switzerland. And don't confuse Nyon with Lyon. Lyon is the headquarter of Interpol. ठीक है? Lyon is the headquarter of Interpol. Question number 6. Consider the following statements with respect to Bal Vatika pilot project and you have to identify the correct statement. So now the Bal Vatika project has been launched in a pilot mode. It has been launched officially. Isse pehle announced hua tha. Ab now isko pilot project mein launch kar diya gaya hai. So do cheezon ki baat hui hai actually. So the Union Education Minister, Mr. Dharmendra Pradhan, has launched National Curriculum Framework for Foundational Stage and Pilot Project of Bal Vatika in 49 KVs across the country. KVs means Central School, Kendra Vidyalaya. Now, this was articulated in NEP 2020. This, we are talking about this framework, National Curriculum Framework for Foundational Stage. It was articulated in NEP 2020 and this curriculum will use play at the core of the curriculum organization and the overall experience of the child. Basically, it seeks to provide stimulating experience फॉर दी चाइल्ड डेवलपमेंट इन ऑल डायमेंशन. ठीक है, ये जो फ्रेमवर्क है इट फोकसेस ऑन द फाउंडेशनल स्टेज ऑफ द चाइल्ड एंड इट्स डेवलपमेंट इन ऑल द डायमेंशन विच आर कॉग्निटिव, सोशो इमोशनल एंड फिजिकल, एंड इट विल ऑल्सो एनेबल द अचीवमेंट ऑफ फाउंडेशनल लिटरेसी एंड न्यूमरेसी ऑफ द चाइल्ड. नाउ वट इज दिस बाल वाटिका पायलट प्रोजेक्ट, इट्स ऑब्जेक्टिव, दीज आर द थ्री ब्रॉड ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ बाल वाटिका प्रोजेक्ट. नंबर वन इज टू मेंटेन गुड हेल्थ एंड वेल बींग ऑफ चाइल्ड. नंबर टू इज टू बिकमिंग prepare them to become effective communicators, right? And number three is to make them become learners, good learners. ठीक है जी. And this project has been launched for children in the age group of 3+, 4+ and 5+ years of age. And अभी के लिए इनको 49 केंद्र विद्यालय में लॉन्च किया गया है. अब for now it has been launched in a pilot mode in the 49 केंद्र विद्यालय, but in future it will be launched pan India. All right, so we have to identify correct statements. It is an initiative of Ministry of Education under NEP. Yes, correct. It has been introduced in all Kendra Vidyalayas across the country. Is that so? No, 49 KVs mein isko introduce kiya hai. It is for students in the age group of 3+, 4+ and 5+ years of age. This is correct. 1 and 3 should be the correct answer because we have to identify the correct statements. Okay, moving ahead to question number 7. Now this is about Quality Council of India. Identify the incorrect statement about Quality Council of India. Now the thing is, why we are discussing about Quality Council of India? Because recently Mr. Jagsher Shah has been appointed as the chairperson of Quality Council of India for a period of 3 years, and that is why we are discussing about this council. Now remember, it is a national body for accreditation set up jointly by central government and industry bodies of the country, right? The objectives are to promote quality in the country through national accreditation of testing, inspection and certification bodies. Jo bhi hamari testing, inspection or certification bodies hai, unko accreditation dena is the objective, and thereby maintaining the quality standards. To create a mechanism for independent third party assessment of products, service and processes. All right, and finally to undertake capacity building initiatives. Now please don't try to learn these objectives. It is pretty much clear from the name of the organization itself that it maintains the quality standards in the country. And how the quality standards can be controlled? By providing accreditation of what? Of testing, of third party of assessment. In sabka jab accreditation mil jayega to of course quality control ho jayegi. Okay, now it is an autonomous non-profit organization established in the year 1997 through a cabinet note by the government of India. And so remember, it is not a statutory body, it is not backed by any act, right? It was established through a cabinet note only. And parent organization is DPIIT, Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, which works under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry, right? And it is headquartered in New Delhi. That's all. इससे ज्यादा पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं है. It is national body for accreditation jointly set up by central government and Indian industry. सही बात है. It is a statutory body established in 1997. Is that a statutory body? No. I have just told you it is not a statutory body. It functions under the Ministry of Consumer Affairs. No. Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Because the parent organization is DPIIT, and DPIIT works under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. All right. And it promotes quality in the country to national accreditation of testing, inspection and certification bodies. So 1 and 4 are correct, but we have to identify the incorrect statements. All right, always focus on the word, whether you have to identify the correct statement or the incorrect statement, right? So 2 and 3 are incorrect, which means option C will be the correct answer. Let's move ahead to question number 8 then. This is again an important question. We have discussed so many times about the lighthouse project, but this time it is in news. So you never know ki abhi jo NABARD ka phase 2 hai usme hi iske bare mein pooch liya jaye, right? 6 lighthouse projects are being built at 6 locations across the country as part of Global Housing Technology Challenge. So basically the question is, which of the following is not among the 6 places where the LHPs are being constructed? Let's jump to the news. So the question is, the lighthouse project was launched in the year 2021, the last year, But why we are discussing it today? Because recently Prime Minister Modi has inaugurated Lighthouse Project at Rajkot under Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban. ठीक है, राजकोट में जो लाइट हाउस प्रोजेक्ट बन रहा था उसको इनॉग्रेट कर दिया गया है, राइट? एंड दैट इज व्हाई इट इज इन न्यूज. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द लाइट हाउस प्रोजेक्ट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दीज आर बीइंग बिल्ट एज पार्ट ऑफ ग्लोबल हाउसिंग टेक्नोलॉजी चैलेंज इंडिया इनिशिएटिव विच वॉज लॉन्च इन 2019. दिस ग्लोबल हाउसिंग टेक्नोलॉजी चैलेंज इंडिया इट वॉज लॉन्च इन 2019 बट लाइट हाउस प्रोजेक्ट वॉज लॉन्च इन 2021. ऑलराइट, तो व्हाट आर दी लाइट हाउस प्रोजेक्ट? ठीक है, ये है क्या बेसिकली? सो दीज आर दी मॉडल हाउसिंग प्रोजेक्ट्स, ठीक है, विद अप्रोक्सीमेटली 1000 हाउसेस इन वन प्रोजेक्ट. एक प्रोजेक्ट में कितने हाउसेस होंगे? 1000. दीज आर दी मॉडल हाउसेस. नाउ व्हाई दीज आर कॉल्ड एज मॉडल हाउसेस? बिकॉज दीज आर बीइंग कंस्ट्रक्टेड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी विच आर सूटेबल टू द जियोक्लाइमेटिक एंड हजार्ड कंडीशंस ऑफ द रीजन, राइट? इसमें नई नई टेक्नोलॉजीज का इस्तेमाल किया जा रहा है एंड दैट इज व्हाई दे आर बीइंग कॉल्ड एज मॉडल हाउसेस. ओके, नाउ जब साइट हैंड ओवर कर दी जाती है टू दी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विच इज कंस्ट्रक्टिंग इट, सो मैक्सिमम 12 मंथ्स में उसको कंप्लीट होना होता है. सो द मैक्सिमम पीरियड फॉर कंप्लीशन ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट इज 12 मंथ्स, राइट? एंड मिनिमम साइज ऑफ हाउस इट इज एज पर द गाइडलाइंस ऑफ पीएम आवास योजना अर्बन. नाउ इसके डिटेल में जाने की जरूरत नहीं है, अगर आपके एग्जाम में स्टेटमेंट आया तो वो यही होगा दैट मिनिमम साइज ऑफ हाउस अंडर लाइट हाउस प्रोजेक्ट इज एज पर द गाइडलाइंस ऑफ पीएम आवास योजना अर्बन. सो इन दैट केस द स्टेटमेंट वुड बी करेक्ट. एंड दीज आर द 6 लोकेशंस वेयर द लाइट हाउस प्रोजेक्ट द लाइट हाउसेज आर बींग कंस्ट्रक्टेड: इंदौर, राजकोट, चेन्नई, रांची, अगरतला एंड लखनऊ. राजकोट वन इज इनॉग्रेटेड एंड चेन्नई वन इज ऑल्सो इनॉग्रेटेड. So 2 are completed, these 4 are under construction. So that's all. So not among the 6 places, Indore is there, Pune is not there. Option C is the correct answer. Pune mein nahi ban raha hai, baaki Chennai, Ranchi, Agartala, Lucknow mein to bani raha. Alright. Aur Rajkot wala inaugurate ho chuka hai. Question number 9. India Urban Housing Conclave 2022 was recently organized by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Headed by Hardeep Singh Puri. Hardeep Singh Puri is the Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas also. During the conclave, PM Awas Yojana Urban Awards 2021 were declared. PM Awas Yojana Urban, I have discussed in very much detail. If you want to know about this scheme, you can search for Government Schemes Anuj Jindal. There you will get a playlist aur usme aapko is scheme ki detail mil jayegi. Theek hai? Which state has been awarded with the Best Performing State Award? ठीक है जी, देखो ये अवार्ड भी हम पहले डिस्कस कर चुके हैं बट क्योंकि ये अभी न्यूज में है सो आई हैव टेकन दिस न्यूज बिकॉज नो वन नोज की नबार्ड फेस टू में पूछ ले, राइट? सो मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स हैज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड द इंडिया अर्बन हाउसिंग कॉन्क्लेव 2022 इन राजकोट इन गुजरात. सो वेयर इट वॉज कंडक्टेड? इन राजकोट. देखो अभी बहुत सारी चीजें ना गुजरात में और हिमाचल प्रदेश में होने वाली है बिकॉज वी ऑल नो इलेक्शंस आर कमिंग. So this conclave is for providing a platform to stakeholders so that they can demonstrate their technologies of housing construction and to mainstream different types of housing construction suitable for different geoclimatic regions of the country. Basically to demonstrate the technology which are suitable for different geoclimatic regions of the country. Technology for what? Technology for housing construction. Okay? Aage badhte hain. So this conclave has 2 major components. First, under first component, there were exhibitions on Swachh Bharat Mission, DNULM, PM Swanidhi Mission, etc. Okay, there are various schemes, there are various landmark schemes which are being implemented by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. So for all those landmark schemes, the exhibition was there. And in the second component, deliberations on various issues of affordable housing, paving way for the future housing. Basically, what are the issues in the affordable housing, how we can achieve the affordable housing, what are the technologies that we can use in affordable housing, all these things were discussed. All right. And now, as the question says, PM Awas Yojana Urban awards were given. So best performing states are these. Number one state was UP, followed by Madhya Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. Right. best state in implementing credit linked subsidy scheme, it was Gujarat, and best state among northeastern and hilly state was Tripura. It is not capital subsidy, it is just credit linked subsidy scheme, right? So that is all. The question is regarding the best performing state. So which state is the best performing state? Uttar Pradesh. Chief Minister is Yogi Adityanath. Question number 10 pe aa jaate. Recently, National Crisis Management Committee met and reviewed the preparedness of central ministries or agencies and state or UT governments for the possible cyclonic storm over the Bay of Bengal. The question is very simple. Who is the chairperson of this committee? Theek hai, so the chairperson of this committee is the Cabinet Secretary of India. And who is the current Cabinet Secretary? Mr. Rajiv Gauba. Rajiv Gauba is the current Cabinet Secretary of India. 11. Recently, REC Limited and Power Finance Corporation Limited. Remember, Power Finance Corporation was recently made Maharatna company. ठीक है, और उसके बाद एक और कंपनी को महारत्ना बनाया गया है. कैन यू नेम दैट कंपनी? राइट डाउन इन द कमेंट्स. अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ पावर साइन MOL, मेमोरेंडम ऑफ लोन एग्रीमेंट विद सतलुज जल विद्युत निगम थर्मल प्राइवेट लिमिटेड. दिस इज सतलुज जल विद्युत निगम SJVN फॉर फाइनेंसिंग दिस मच मेगावाट कोल बेस्ड बक्सर थर्मल पावर प्लांट. इन विच स्टेट दिस प्लांट इज लोकेटेड? सो बक्सर इज इन बिहार. And this plant is also located in Bihar. Option D is the correct answer. And as always, Nitish Kumar is the Chief Minister of Bihar. Nitish Kumar paida hi hue the Bihar ka Chief Minister banne ke liye. Aur jab tak wo mujhe lagta hai zinda hai, tab tak wo Bihar ke CM rahenge. Which ministry has organized a 2-day national training workshop on People's Plan Campaign 2022 to prepare district, block, or gram panchayat development plans for the year 23-24? Now you just have to identify the ministry. There is no need to go into the details of this training workshop. Not at all required. It is Ministry of Panchayati Raj headed by Giriraj Singh. Giriraj Singh's Lok Sabha constituency is Begusarai, and Begusarai is again in Bihar. Question number 13. Recently, Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced 4th positive indigenization list. Now, somewhere you have heard about negative list as well. So both are the same thing. The names are different. This is positive indigenization list and that is negative import list. Negative import list and positive indigenization list, both are same. ठीक है, और इसका मतलब ये होता है, whatever items are included in the list will not be imported. जितना भी item इसके अंदर है वो import नहीं किया जाएगा, and all the items will be procured from the domestic manufacturers only. Okay? So question is, how many items are there in the fourth list? So fourth list include 101 items. Option E is the correct answer. And the last question for today, recently Prime Minister Modi launched Mission Schools of Excellence. It is aimed at strengthening the education infrastructure by setting up of new classrooms, smart classrooms, computer labs. It is partially funded by the World Bank. It is the initiative of which state government? So batao, kaun sa state government ho sakta hai ye? It is Gujarat. Option C is the correct answer. All right. So that's all, guys. I hope all the questions are clear and their explanations are also clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye. Take care and God bless.